Hello, my dear friends, and welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Joyce Joy, and today in this lecture, we will discuss about Juvenile Justice Care and Protection Act of 2015. Now, if you look at the current affair, in 2016, a 17-year-old murdered his 3-year-old neighbor. Now, the 17-year-old is a juvenile according to the definition of Juvenile Justice Act. But the Mumbai City Juvenile Justice Board and the Bombay High Court had given differing opinion. Now, if you look at the opinions, the Mumbai City Juvenile Justice Board gave the opinion that this 17-year-old should be tried as an adult because this is a heinous crime. But the Bombay High Court said that he should be considered as a juvenile or as a minor. So the Mumbai High Court and the Bombay City Juvenile Justice Board had differing opinion in this regard. So considering this current affair, we will analyze Juvenile Justice Care and Protection Act of 2015. Now let us first briefly understand what is Juvenile Justice Act. So Juvenile Justice Act was brought in the year 2000 and this was amended in 2015. Now in 2015, the original act was amended with a provision that allowed children in conflict with law to be tried as adults under certain circumstances. So the amendment of 2015 allowed a special provision that in certain circumstances where there is a conflict with the law, children under the age of 18, that is minors, can also be tried or can be prosecuted as adults. Now, if you look at Juvenile Justice Act, the Act defines a child as a person below the age of 18 years. Now, the amendment which was brought in the year 2015 distinguishes children in the age group of 16 to 18 years as a category, as a special category, wherein which they can be tried as adults or they can be considered as adults if they have committed or if they are alleged to have committed a heinous offense. Now, what is the definition of a heinous offense or what is a heinous offense? A heinous offense is an offense for which the punishment is at least 7 years. So, any offense that will attract a punishment of 7 years and above is considered to be a heinous offense. But what is important here is that the amended act in 2015 does not make it mandatory that within the age group of 16 to 18 years, the offenders or the alleged offenders should be considered as adults. So this is only a provision which can be considered in some special certain circumstances. So this is the amendment which was made in 2015 to the original act of 2000. Now, let us understand why this amendment was made in the year 2015. So, this amendment was proposed by the Ministry of Women and Child Development and this was proposed in the year 2014. So, following the proposal of the Women and Child Development Ministry's proposal in 2015, the original Act of 2000 was amended. Now, this was at the backdrop of the Delhi gang rape. And the Delhi gang rape, which happened in 2012, among the many offenders, one was a minor. The offender was 17 years old. And the Ministry of Women and Child Development also cited an example of increase in the number of offenses in the country, especially heinous offenses. And this was within the age group of 16 to 18 years. So this is the reason why the ministry proposed an amendment or a change to the original Juvenile Justice Act of 2000. Now, if you look at the J.S. Verma Committee, the J.S. Verma Committee was constituted in order to recommend amendments to the Juvenile Justice Act. And this committee recommendation stated that it was not inclined to reduce the age of juvenile from 18 to 16 years. So, the age of juvenile cannot be reduced from 18 to 16 years. But instead, what could have been done was that for heinous offenses, a special category of 16 to 18 years could be created and under some special circumstances, they can be tried as adults. So that is why the amendment was made in the year 2015 to the original Juvenile Justice Act. Now moving on, let us understand the criteria under the Juvenile Justice Act in order to try a minor as an adult. Now, according to the section 15 of the Juvenile Justice Act, there are three criteria that the Juvenile Justice Board in the concerned district. So this concerned district Juvenile Justice Board can consider the trial of a minor as an adult, and the three circumstances or the criteria. First one is the mental and the physical capacity of the alleged person. So this is the first criteria. Second one is the ability of the alleged person to understand the consequences of the crime or the misconduct. Now third one is the circumstances, whether the child who was below the age of 18 years, whether the child knew about the circumstances in which the offenses were committed. So these are the three criteria which the Juvenile Justice Board in each district, in the concerned district, can consider as a criteria to try the children between the age group of 16 to 18 years as adults. Now, if the board, that is the Juvenile Justice Board, finds that the child can be tried as an adult, the case is again transferred to a designated children's court. Now, in the second stage, the children's court has to decide whether the board's decision is correct. So, this will go through two phases or two stages, and only after that, a juvenile or a minor between the age group of 16 to 18 would be considered as an adult for the case or the trial of the case. Now, let us come to the case we were discussing in this lecture. Let us come to the current affair and how it is related, or how the criteria is related here. Let us understand. Now, we have seen that in the first stage, the Juvenile Justice Board will consider the three criteria. And again, if the board is satisfied that the case or the alleged person can be considered as an adult, then this is transferred to the children's court at the second stage. Now, in this case that we were discussing, the children's court and also the Juvenile Justice Board in the district considered two reports. And this was the first one, the probation officer's social investigation report, and the second one is the government hospital's mental health report. Now, if we look at the probation officer's report, we see that the child or the family of the child did not had any background of any criminal record or any criminal background. And secondly, this report called the child or the minor as highly manipulative. And third one, in the report it was mentioned that the child had confessed that the crime happened accidentally. And fourthly, in the observation home, the child was given counseling, and a special mention was given regarding his focus on the studies, and he took up the examination and he cleared the examination. Now, if we look at all these, the important highlights in the report, we see that the criteria is not fulfilled. Now, the ability to understand the consequences, this is absent because the crime happened accidentally and the child or his family had no criminal background. And the circumstances of the crime, that is also much accidental. Now, the second one is regarding the mental health report. The mental health report said that the child had no psychiatric complaints at present, which means that the child is very normal, and the child also suffers from no mental incapacity. So this was the two reports which were considered by the Juvenile Justice Board and the Children's Court. Now, in the current affair, we have seen that the High Court, that is the Bombay High Court, said that the accused should be considered as a minor. Now, the High Court has also considered these reports, and based on the report and also the highlights of the report, the High Court also has come up with an observation that the child should be considered as only a minor, not as an adult, for the purpose of the trial of this case. You can find the PDF of this lecture on our website www.studyiq.com. You can follow my Facebook page for more video updates. Thank you.